Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So today we are going to talk about key block. Not key-ish block, it's a key block. So we've talked about a few logic blocks about if, each, await. And today we're going to talk about key. So what is the key block? Well, have you ever have this scenario where you want to recreate elements or components when something has changed, right? It's not like you want to, it's not if where you, because of the condition, you want to show a height. It's more like if this condition, if this variable has changed, I want to recreate component, recreate the components or recreate elements. Sounds vague, right? Who wants to do that? Well, I will show you an example and you understand why. Before that, let me show you how to use a key block. Right, so over here, I have one example, a very simple example. I have an input and I have a button. So input is something I can type, and button is when I click, it will increment the count. Sounds simple, right? Okay, so what if whenever the count changes, I want to recreate the input? Okay, don't ask me why, but what if I want to do this, right? So if I want to do this, what I can do is I can come with here and say key. So every time when you have a logic block, you start with the curly brackets and a hash sign. So this logic block is key. So we're gonna start with this and we're gonna end with key. And in the logic block, we say key and then we write an expressions. So this is kind of like your reactive declaration or reactive statement, right? You can put in any kind of expressions, you treat it like a reactive statement. So any variable within that expression changes, this whole thing will be recreated. So the input will be recreated. So I'm going to pass in count. So every time when I click the number, increment the number, when I change count, this input box is recreated. So how do you know it's recreated? When I type something, right, and I click this, you see that what I type in is gone, right? I didn't go and change the value of the input, but rather that input, the previous input with all this value is thrown away and a new input is created in replace of replacing this current input, right? So when I click, I create a new one and replace it. That's why you don't see anything. So this is the key block. Let me clarify a bit. The key block will, whenever the expression has changed and the value of that expression is different. So it depends on two conditions, right? First is whenever the expression is changed, it will be kind of, you will reevaluate the expressions like your reactive statement and to compare the result of the expression. And whenever the result, which is the value of the expression, is changed, then the content inside the key block will be recreated, right? So if you have input here, the input will be recreated. If you have a few divs or content, for example, here I have another count and a divs, all this will be recreated. So what is so good about this? What is the purpose of having this key block, right? So one thing I can show you, which is based on something we haven't learned yet, but I'm gonna show you, which is to add transitions. So transitions, so let me do like a fade transition. So for transition, transition is like an animation where it applies to an element when it is created and added to the DOM, or when it is destroyed or removed from the DOM. Right, so this animation will play when it comes in, or it will play when it goes out. So I can add an animation to fade in when this div is created. So now whenever I increase the number over here, you see that this div is destroyed and created, right? Because this count value of count has changed. So this div will be recreated every time. And therefore, you see that every time when it recreates, you replay this fade transition. That's why you can see that it's fading in every time when you change the value. So this is probably one of the use cases that you would want to use with key. But there's another case where I feel it's even, it's not just about animations. There are cases where you want to recreate components. So over here, I prepared another example where over here you can see that this looks like a chat app where you can click on different users and you can type message, try to chat with the person, right? Right now you're talking to Charlie or Ben or Dawson, right? So of course you see, but you over here you see that does not really work over here. Although we have a list of names, and whenever we click on one of it, we will change the selected friend, right? I use each block. I use a radio box to bind group. We've learned that before. And we right over here we pass the selected friend to this component called chat. So in a chat component, what we have over here is a we have a props called friend, and we read out the name. We have chats, and we try to load the chat. What we didn't do over here is that whenever a friend change, we actually have to reactively update all the different inner states. Right? For example, over here the name is initialized whenever we create a chat component, and whenever this props change, we actually never update this variable name. That's why you see talking to name is always the same person even if I switch to different people. So I can use reactive statements that redeclare the name every time when I change, right? I'm talking to Ben, I'm talking to Alfred, I'm talking to Dawson. Right? Same thing goes with messages over here. When I type something, what you expect is whenever I switch to different users, you want to clear this input over here. Right, so this input uses a bind value to bind the value of the input to the variable called messages, which is initialized to be empty string. Makes sense? Fair enough. But now we kind of have to, you know, whenever name has changed, we want to initialize something, right? So we create a function called init and or reset, right? We want to reset. So we create a function called reset. Let me write it over here, reset. So our reset, what reset do is it will set message to an empty string. So hopefully when I type something and I switch to different user, it will reset by setting an empty setting message to empty string. Right, and as you can see over here, also one thing that is important is the chat message. When I switch to different users, I need to load a different chat messages. So I need to come over here. Instead of calling it over here, I need to paste it in the resets, right? It's kind of like reset whenever you change the name. Right? It sounds weird when you change friend, whenever the friend has changed, we'll call reset, right? Although we're not gonna, for now, we are not doing anything yet, but probably we will use the friend. Maybe we use a friend's name to load the chat. So when I switch over to Ben, you see that it's loading a Ben's message. I switch to Dawson, you see that it's loading a Dawson's message. But if I switch quickly, you see that it loads Charlie's and then Ben's and then Alfred's and then Ben. Right? Because it's the same components over here. When our logic is quite simple, we just call this load chat every time when we change the friend, and whenever it's come back, it will set update the chats, right? So you can see if I change quickly, I'll update the load chat will be fired a few times subsequently very fast, and whenever it come the first one come back, so update the chats, and then the next one will come and update, right? So this one, whenever we change, when we call this function every time, we kind of have to actually cancel the previous one before we, so it's like a reset. Your reset, we need to cancel previous ones before we load a new one. So this is something we need to do as well. So there's a lot of things we need to do, like reset things whenever we switch to a different friends when you're looking at a chat app. And actually, you know what? There's a very simple way of doing it, right? We learn about key, and I say that whenever the key's expression has changed, you will recreate, right? You'll destroy the elements and recreate elements, or destroy components and recreate the component instance. So this is actually a perfect scenario or use case to use a key. Let me undo all this, right? Let me undo all this by say let name equals to friend's name. Let message to be an empty string. And then we call a load chat, right? We call load chat over here. So this is a perfect simple component where we don't have much logics over here. Everything is initialized over here at the start, and all the states are initialized at the start. We don't really handle whenever, like, we don't really care whether a friend handle the case where friend has changed. We just assume that it's not gonna change, right? In this component, so the logic within the component is much simpler. And when we come over here, we can actually use a key block to say that. Whenever the friend has changed, we want to recreate this chat component, right? Whenever it's changed, we recreate. So things that you initialize, whenever it will be kind of reinitialized, because you destroy this component and create a new one, right? Definitely, you will have a new, brand new component with everything initialized at the initial states. Right, so your code over here is much simpler. You don't have to care about whenever friends change, you want to do something, you can initialize all the things you want, and the thing that you need to do is just throw it away and recreate a new one, right? So the state over here that we in this example is fairly simple, right? Only a message fetching some data and that's all. But if you have slightly more complex components where you have more states that is defaults to different kind of values based on different kind of props and things like that, an easier way for you to is just to destroy the component and recreate if you want to reset the whole state, right? Rather than having a function that tries to figure out what to reset and what not and handle all the things, right? So that's why there's this logic block called key, which really helpful when you want to destroy whatever elements or components within a block whenever an expression, the value of an expression has changed. And this is useful when you want to reset everything within a component or elements, or you just want to recreate elements because you know that you have you have transitions applied to elements so that they can replay it whenever it's coming in, right? So this is key block. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. If you have anything to ask, feel free to comment down below. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that when you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.